अस्सलाम वालेकुम टू एवरीवन हु इज़ वाचिंग दिस वीडियो लेक्चर। दिस इज़ वकार फ्रॉम कैमरे इंटरनेशनल साइंस कॉलेज एट तलागंग। वेलकम टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट इन क्लास रूम ट्रेनिंग वीडियो लेक्चर। आई होप यू वुड बी फाइन एंड यू वुड हैव प्रिपेयर्ड ऑल द लेक्चर वेदर दे वर डिलीवर्ड बाय मी आर सर मुमताज। डियर स्टूडेंट, इन दिस लेक्चर यू कैन लर्न अबाउट अ वेरी कॉमन टॉपिक, बट मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स डू नॉट हैव एनी स्पेसिफिक आइडिया अबाउट दिस टॉपिक। मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट मिसलीड this topic. So in this lecture you can learn very well about this topic. It's about use of it. How can you use it in your daily conversation or in written form? When we talk about it, it means it. इसका जो उर्दू में तर्जमा है वो ये के मानों में किया जाता है, but it can be used in different ways. So right now in this lecture you are going to be taught about it. First, replacement between it and this. When you are talking about it, you can replace it with this. जहाँ पर आपने it का इस्तेमाल करना है dear student, वहाँ पर आप this का इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं. But how? It is associated with non-living. When you are talking about non-living, like table, like chair, you can use it. And when you are talking about living and non-living, this can be used both for living and non-living. But it is specific only for non-living things. You cannot apply it with living thing, like a person, theek hai, like a man. I cannot use it for me. As an intro, I often say that this is Vakar. I cannot say it is Vakar. Even though in modern English it is used for also living thing, but in grammatical point of view, you cannot use it for living thing. So first of all, first rule is replacement between it and this. जहाँ पर लगता है वहाँ पर आप this लगा सकते हैं, but लेकिन जब living का सवाल होगा you cannot utilize it. Example, first of all, here I'm going to take example in Urdu and after that I will translate into English. ये एक किताब है. You can write in this form. It is a book. You can also this sentence like this. This is a book. Here you have made up replacement between it and this. You can use also it and you can also use this. These two terms are replacement because book is non-living. When we are talking about non-living, we can use it as well as this. So there is no difference between these two sentences. These two sentences are giving the same meaning. It is also giving the same meaning and it is also giving the same meaning. ये भी इसका भी मतलब ये एक किताब है और इसका मतलब भी क्या है, ये एक किताब है. I take another example. It is an idea. You can also use this is an idea because an idea is an abstract noun. You cannot feel, you cannot touch this thing, and when you cannot touch anything, that particular thing is called abstract noun. So here in this example, the idea is taken as abstract noun. So here we can also replace because it is not living thing. It and this can also be replaced. You can use it and you can also use this at replacement of it. So both the sentences are giving the same idea, same meaning. There is no difference in the meaning of both sentences. So but when we talk about living, it is Vakar, wrong. This is wrong way to introduce yourself. You cannot say it is vakar. You will have to say, you will always say, this as you already heard in my intro when I was talking about start of the lecture. There I have already said this is vakar. I have not said it is vakar. You will always say this is vakar because you cannot use it for living because it is living. आप जानदार के साथ कभी भी जो है वो दिस पर्टिकुलरली फॉर ह्यूमन आप ह्यूमन के साथ एनिमल के साथ आई हैव ऑल्सो सीन इन मैनी स्टोरीज दैट द वर्ड इट इज यूज फॉर क्रो और काउ एलिफेंट गोट सो बट फॉर ह्यूमन यू कैन नॉट अप्लाई द टर्म ऑफ इट यू आर बाउंड टू यूज दिस So it is the rule number one. You can take a screenshot and after that I am going to teach you further about this topic. So I hope you would have taken a screenshot of it. So rule number one is clear that you can make a replacement of it with this. You can replace it with this and you can also replace this with it. But only for non-living. You cannot use it for living. You can only use this for living thing. But this and it both can be used for non-living. So here I'm going to erase this. Rule number one, right now I'm moving toward the second rule, which is also related to it, and it is also a very important rule. Most of the time I have already heard that the people say, today I'm not going there, today will be holiday, yesterday, Monday, Sunday. ठीक है यू कैन नॉट स्टार्ट अ सेंटेंस विद द नेम ऑफ ए डे रिमेंबर रूल नंबर टू नो सेंटेंस कैन स्टार्ट विद नेम ऑफ ए डे You cannot say that, for example, tomorrow will be holiday. You cannot say. It is a wrong concept. Here you are going to use it as a subject. You will always say आप हमेशा कहोगे it will be holiday tomorrow. You would have to always say this that you are not going to say tomorrow will be holiday. It is a wrong sentence. You are bound to use it will be holiday tomorrow. Yani kal chutti hogi. You are going to take it as a subject. You always take it as a subject in these types of sentences. I am going to take another example which will be helpful for understanding this topic. I am it is Monday, today. You cannot say today is Monday. You will always say it is Monday today. Most of the time you have seen that most of the people write Monday, today is Monday. You cannot say that today is Saturday. You cannot say today is Sunday. You cannot say today is Monday. So you will always say it is Monday today. Here you have also taken it as a subject. It means that this rule is clear that no sentence can start with the name of a day. Aap kisi jumle ka aagaz kisi din ke naam se nahin kar sakte. Here you are going to take it as a subject instead of a day. Aap kisi day ko start pe nahin la sakte. You are bound to use it. So you can also take a screenshot of it, and after that I am going to teach you further about this topic. I hope you would have taken a screenshot. So I'm moving toward the rule number 3, and it is the part first of it. It is part first. Second part will also be discussed in upcoming lecture. So third one, it as a subject introductory word. Sometime you are unable to locate a subject in a sentence. Many times you have faced this problem that you try to make a sentence but you are not able to make that sentence because you are unable to locate a subject. How can you locate, how can get your subject? There you are going to use it. There are many cases. For example, कुर्सी है, ठीक है. यू कैन नॉट मेक दिस सेंटेंस. यू आर अनएबल टू लोकेट दैट व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सब्जेक्ट विल बी यूज इन दिस सेंटेंस. सो हेयर यू कैन यूटिलाइज इट. इट इज अ चेयर. यू कैन ऑल्सो यूज दिस. दिस इज अ चेयर. इट इज अ चेयर. कुर्सी है यानी इट इज अ चेयर. समटाइम यू कैन नॉट लोकेट the subject, there you are going to use the subject, it as a subject. So in these three rules we have learned about the use of it. You can use it as a subject, you can use it as the replacement of this, but only for living. You can only for non-living. You cannot use it for living thing. So in this you can use it as an introductory word. In many sentences you have seen that it is used as a introductory word. There are three words which can be used as an introductory word. Number one there, number two here, and number three is it. So in this lecture you have learned about the use of it from different ways, and it is the part one. And in the part second I will further teach you about the use of it in different situation, in different sentences. So dear student, I hope you would have understood all the lecture. Whatever has been taught in this lecture, I hope you would have understood. So take care of yourself. See you next time. Allah Hafiz.